Welcome back to our M36 Tank Destroyer Restoration Project. In the last video, I shared the details of this tank and the fact that we got it into the shop. Since then, we've had quite a bit of progress disassembling the vehicle. We're removing the gun tube assembly before we remove the turret. The M3 90mm gun weighs approximately 2,200 pounds and is 15 foot long. We used our 20-ton shop crane to remove the gun along with a chain come along for adjusting the balance. This gun was fairly easy to remove. Basically, four bolts on either side of the gun secure the trunnion caps. As mentioned in the last video, we're restoring this tank back to original as it came off the assembly line in 1944. So this engine has to come out and make room for the American-made 4GAA 1100 cubic inch gas engine. What we're taking out is a Soviet-made V12 diesel that was retrofitted during its use in Yugoslavia. With no manuals at hand and the basic inspection of the engine mounting system, we knew the clutch and flywheel had to be removed to allow the engine to move back out from underneath the bulkhead and clear the existing mounts. However, removing the entire clutch and flywheel assembly was a no-go because of damage, so we clearanced the mounts to give way for the removal. The leftover engine mounts were very robust and ran the length of the engine, all welded solid to the hull floor. It took us nearly 3 days to cut and grind all of the additional metal that supported the V12. Now we're back to the original engine compartment and ready for the GAA. We're getting ready to take the track off both sides and roll the tank off of it. Guys are starting right now, busting nuts and bolts loose.
How you doing? So we got to loosen these two bolts, which keep this clamp down, and then the center bolt we actually run in, and that spreads it apart underneath here to take the tension off it. And then this needs to slide out because it's on a spline that keeps it locked in place so it can't ever accidentally move. There.
Right there.
There you go. We should be loose enough to get the track links undone. Now we'll move to the front of the tank and
break the tracks apart.
Break the track. Yep.
So we have these track jacks that go on here and clip on end connectors and skip one end connector and pull the track together to take tension off it so that we can get this one end connector apart. We put them on the inside and the outside and remove those and bust the track in two.
That should be enough.
This is part of the end connector. This is a wedge bolt with the nut on the end of it. We took this one out of this particular one right here. This is where we're gonna break the track, but just for explanation purposes, it goes in between the two track links of the separate tracks. It coincides with a little flat spot on both of these. And as it sinks in there, it locks this track end connector in with the track pins. And that's what keeps the track going.
So this will pull that end connector off, we hope.
Doing anything?
Oh yeah.
It'll probably pop.
I heard something.
Broke it.
Broke it.
That's the wrong pop. It broke off the little tooth that went inside that where that bolt was on the end connector. And obviously now it's rendered useless. So we're gonna have to do plan B. This vehicle has been out in the elements for about 80 years, which means a lot of the metal parts are going to be seized together. We're gonna do what the old method was along with this. Is try to bead on it from the outside on the inside of that with the tanker bar. Let me tighten her up just a little bit.
She's winking.
Coming off. Gotta get it. All right.
Smack it on the top side.
Perfect.
2 hours later.
So what we're trying to do is put that pin right there down inside that hole where that bolt came through. Now he's going to tighten it up. So that holds this thing from coming up, so we can adjust it so it always stays parallel with the track link.
We need to put some heat to that again.
We put a little bit, but we might just do it, get tight on there, and let's do it again. Ready for some rat-a-tat?
Rat-a-tat.
Top one. The bottom one's moving further than the top one now. There we go. There we go.
I got it.
You got it.
What, can you pry the track up? Got it.
There we go.
Now to do it all over again.
That's all there is to it.
What we're doing here is we're coming in with a flame wrench, because what we were doing before kept breaking all our tools. So we're gonna get this done most rickety tick, plus lunchtime's coming up. So we're gonna cut this off. Everything should be warm now. It should just fall apart. Yeah. Hammer time.
That didn't fall apart.
Perfect.
I got it.
Well, now what we got to do is move the tank backwards and roll it off the track, all the way off the track. Perfect. You're good. What we're going to do now is clean up the area, but first we're going to section these tracks in probably 4 to 6 pieces in here so we can pile them up on the forklift so we can manage them. Next after that, we're gonna move over to our tank, which is gonna be back in its original position over here. And we're gonna pull the piece parts out of the inside, and then we're gonna pull the whole turret off of it. The trick to getting the turret off is keeping it level for safety. We kept it straight by using the extra come along to adjust the level as needed. After the turret was free, we placed the turret on jack stands until we're ready for it for the next process. If you want to catch the next video in the project, hit the subscribe button and the bell. We'll try to have the next video in the series up in a few weeks.